DaVinci Resolve 17.4 includes a host of new features to enhance your post-production workflows. This update transforms the speed of DaVinci Resolve to work up to 5 times faster on Apple MacBook Pro models with M1 Pro and M1 Max chips. With this massive speed increase, you can now playback, edit, and grade 8K projects even faster, and can work with up to 12 streams of 8K footage. The update also increases the decoding speed of 12K Blackmagic RAW files, making it over 3 times faster, and the DaVinci Neural Engine performance is up to 4 times faster for real-time face recognition, object detection, and smart reframing. DaVinci Resolve Studio 17.4 also includes integration with Dropbox and Dropbox Replay. You can now render directly into Dropbox for easy video review and approval. Frame-accurate coloured markers, comments and annotations made in Dropbox Replay are almost instantaneously synced to your DaVinci Resolve timeline. On the edit page, there have been a number of improvements to the timeline. Individual timeline gaps can now be marked with in and out points using the Mark Selection command or pressing Shift A. Audio clip gain adjustments can also be more precisely made by holding the Shift key when dragging the volume overlay. Navigating quickly between timeline tabs is now possible using a customizable keyboard shortcut. Simply open the keyboard customization window and set your desired shortcut to easily move to the next timeline tab. And any unneeded timeline tabs can now be closed with a middle click. Speed editor functionality has been improved in the edit page, allowing you to cut multi-camera clips using the speed editor's camera buttons. Single press the camera number to add a cut at the playhead position, or double press it to switch the current angle. And adding subtitles to your timelines has also been refined. Subtitle backgrounds now automatically resize correctly to fit the text, and when adding a new subtitle, the text box automatically becomes active, allowing you to type your subtitle text straight away. Changes to edit page effects include the ability to be able to asymmetrically trim video or audio transitions. Simply hold the command or control key when making your selection to be able to trim just one side of the transition. The easing of keyframe clip positions in the timeline is now much simpler with the improved position curves, providing more intuitive control over the acceleration along the motion path. Choosing the correct composite modes is also faster. Simply move your mouse through the list to see the highlighted composite mode previewed directly in the viewer. And the new 3D keyer has also been updated. Real-time black and white highlight gives precise feedback when making selections. And a new pop-up details each stroke's RGB selection, allowing you to select and even remove a specific stroke. And the new despill slider allows you to adjust the level of despill applied. Detailed key refinement controls, including the option to display the key map as a viewer overlay, make this one of the most powerful keyers available. And if you create your own custom fusion effects, titles and transitions, it's now easier to organize these for use on the edit page. Simply place the fusion template in an appropriately titled folder in the fusion templates location on your system. Any fusion templates in this folder will then be displayed in that category in the edit page effects library. The Text Plus tool has had numerous improvements to character styling and animation, including support for combined glyphs and right-to-left layouts for Arabic, Hebrew, and other languages. Vertical text support has also been improved with better handling of layout, character rotation, line direction, and even underlining. And for supported fonts, you can now choose between stylistic sets of characters. Finally, timeline markers of a specific colour can now be exported as chapter markers for QuickTime and MP4 formats. Just select the option in the render settings on the deliver page and choose which coloured markers you want to use as chapters. And when choosing any of the YouTube presets, you can use the timeline markers to automatically create video chapters.
In the Color page, the DaVinci Resolve 17.4 updates accommodate emerging industry standards, improve and expand the Openfx library, and feature multiple interface improvements that will simplify and speed up your grading workflow. To begin, automatic color management takes much of the guesswork out of setting up a project for color grading. In the project settings, when the color science is first set to DaVinci YRGB color managed, automatic color management is on by default. This reduces the color processing mode to just two options, SDR or HDR. These will quickly establish a working color space and gamut for standard and high dynamic range projects. The output color space dropdown features only the most predominant output standards. Click Save, and you're good to go. Color management can be especially helpful in projects that feature a variety of video standards. With a few clicks, you can bring them to a similar starting point and begin grading. You can disable automatic color management to bring back the extended list of color processing modes and output color spaces. And, as before, you can select Custom in the color processing mode to access the full list of color management parameters. Another exciting addition to DaVinci Resolve's color management is the support for the latest ACES version 1.3, with gamut compression, new CSC transforms, and other improvements. The OpenFX library has seen many improvements to its existing effects, and features two new additions. Halation emulates the light reflections and scatter found in film stock, a look that has previously required multiple nodes to achieve. The custom mixer allows you to combine effects and grades with much finer control. In blend mode, you can set a composite type and adjust the RGB strength to achieve the perfect balance of your nodes, while combine mode opens up individual and offset controls for more nuanced mixing. Some changes in the node editor will speed up how you interact with nodes and make it easier to monitor your grading workflow. When hovering over a node, the tooltips indicate the name of an applied effect or lookup table. When dragging a connector to a mixer node, such as the parallel, layer, or key mixers, inputs automatically appear to accommodate additional nodes in the stack. Other interface changes allow you to more quickly navigate the color page's primary and secondary palettes. Use the individual tool icons in the top right corner to access different palette modes in the color wheels, curves, qualifier, tracker, and other palettes. Hover over these icons to see their name in the tooltip. When tracking in the window or magic mask palettes, you can track forward and back with a single action. This is helpful for many tracking workflows where the optimal starting point for a track might be in the middle of a clip. First, pick your optimal starting frame and make your initial selection as usual. Then click track forward and reverse to allow the tracker to analyze the clip in both directions. The resulting track will be completed across the whole clip with a keyframe in the tracker graph to mark the frame you started from. Disabled clips appear gray in the mini timeline, giving you a representation of the media hidden from the thumbnail timeline. In the viewer, right-click the audio icon to reveal volume controls. This setting will affect the monitoring levels across all DaVinci Resolve pages, but will not impact the actual volume of the timeline's audio clips. When you have Dolby Vision enabled in the project settings, you will see a clip filter option to isolate clips based on their Dolby Vision analysis or trim status. This will simplify the process of preparing your timeline for Dolby Vision delivery and ensure all clips are trimmed prior to render.
The Fairlight page is packed with new features based on feedback from audio professionals, such as multi-channel output for Linux systems and support for VST3 plugins for both Mac and Windows platforms. In the Fairlight mixer, there's now manual plugin control on each channel strip, so you can quickly drag to reorder plugins, move them to another channel, or option drag to duplicate them from track to track, or bus to bus. There's also improved user-defined processing, so you can choose the order of the effects, built-in dynamics, and EQ processing independently for each track with a single click. The Fairlight timeline includes enhanced gain controls for each clip, so you can option-click to set new keyframes and command or shift-click for multiple keyframe selections. In Edit Selection mode, you can drag a range for ganged keyframe control. You can even show or hide the clip gain line in the Timeline View Options menu, which is now on the left side of the Timeline toolbar, just like the Edit page. Hiding the clip gain line makes it easier to see the automation curves while mixing. And with DaVinci Resolve 17.4, automation curves display current values with a dark line when no automation is present, and a bright line for automated parameters. In the Improved Edit Index, you can select clips, and even search for and select multiple clips directly in the index, allowing fast access to apply changes to multiple clips at once, like adjusting levels and adding effects to all selected clips at the same time. Navigating to Timeline Markers now selects the marker, so you can press M to open the marker dialog, press Tab to toggle through the active fields, and press Escape to close. Dragging fades in the timeline is an easy way to finesse your edits. To apply custom fades to a range of clips at once, there's the Batch Fade settings in the Fairlight menu. Here you can enable Fade In, Crossfade, or Fade Out, choose the shape, fade limit in milliseconds or frames, the length, and option to override existing fades. Select a range in the timeline and apply the batch fades. You can even assign a shortcut in the keyboard customization window. With DaVinci Resolve 17.4, all audio transitions and fades added on the edit page appear as fades in the Fairlight page for seamless picture editing to professional audio workflows and precision control of each fade in the Fairlight timeline. Finally, in the Tracks Index, you can now change the order of tracks or buses to customize your timeline and mixer. Just drag the bus to a different position in the track list, and the interface updates accordingly. These are just some of the exciting new features that you'll find in DaVinci Resolve 17.4. If you'd like more information about DaVinci Resolve, go to blackmagicdesign.com.